As we recognize this very important initiative, the Royal Gazette's Drive for Change campaign to improve road safety in Bermuda. For the entire month of March, the focus will be impaired driving. How do we prevent it, and why does it keep happening? The stigma, or I should say the mistruth, that everyone can drink and still drive on our roads needs to end.
It is the responsibility of everyone to address this issue and take responsibility. From the government right down to the average citizen, our roads have to be safe for those who drive, those who walk, those who ride.
Educating the driving public on good driving skills and habits is paramount, and will be a major tool in tackling bad driving. One life lost on our roads is one life too many.
Thoughts and prayers are no longer sufficient. I have seen government after government pay lip service to what is now a crisis, and we now need action.
Many, even most clients who participate in the Bermuda DUI Education Program have driven impaired many times, sometimes hundreds of times, even thousands of times in some cases. We, the Bermuda people, need to reconsider this cultural behavior of driving while impaired. People are dying and getting injured on our roads, and much of it is related to drinking and driving. We are losing young people with plenty of talents, skills, and potential.
We have a huge problem with impaired driving in the Bermuda community. That is a social issue. We have to work hard to stamp that out and reduce our collisions and certainly reduce our fatalities. We can do that by not impaired driving, and also I encourage people that if you're with somebody who is drinking, is to discourage them from driving or take their keys. We all have a role to play to reduce the numbers of impaired driving in the community.